this video, we are going to talk about our Macaron Vanity Committee, the two customers we chose through the contest on our app, and diagnose their skincare routine to give the best product recommendations we can. So stay tuned.
Hi guys, this is me Suhina from Macaron, and I'm here with one of the most awaited videos for you all. So let's get started. So some of you all might be knowing about Macaron's Vanity Committee. So MVC process is here in place at Macaron to make sure that you all get the best product for your skin type. We understand the struggle of achieving healthy skin. We at Macaron don't want to bring you with just anything. We strive to not compromise on our quality, and that's why our MVC process has strict guidelines that promises to bring only the best of skincare to you all to tackle your skin concerns. On our Macaron community, on our Macaron app, we actually saw that you all have quite a few skin concerns and worries, and we thought it'd be a great idea to address them. So that's what we did. We hosted a round of Q&A on our Macaron community where we asked you all to post your skin concerns, worries with pictures so that we can diagnose them, and also post your morning and night skincare routine. So what we've done now is we've picked a few of you for whom we will diagnose your skincare for absolutely free. But we still always recommend to consult your dermatologist for any skin concerns that you have.
For Richie's skincare concern, we're going to talk about her skincare concerns, her skincare routine that she's currently doing, and the product recommendations that we have to make. So please stay tuned if you are somebody who has comedones or whiteheads. Don't miss out.
Having said that, let's start with the first customer that we've picked to diagnose her skin. So her name is Richie. So Richie is 25 years old, and she has shared with us her skincare concerns pictures as well as her skincare routines. So let's start with diagnosing Richie's skincare concerns. But before we actually dig into that, let's see what she has described to us about her skincare concern. So Richie says that she has PCOD. She gets a lot of small acne that turn into dark spots. She also says that she's been facing with pigmentation for 5 years. It's a vicious cycle. I get acne and it turns into dark spots, with old ones slowly fading. We can understand how this can be so tiresome for the customer and for you all to just trying to write the right match. So that's why we're here trying our best to help you all. Richie has also shared her pictures of her concerns. So let us have a look. So as we see that she does have dark spot problem as well as active acne problem. When we look into Richie's concerns, we believe that it looks like comedones. So comedones are an early stage of acne that occurs after sebum hardens the skin. So in this case, thankfully, inflammation is not that severe compared to the other types of acne. It is not red as the active acne usually are. This is a type of acne that you can experience skin improvement easily if you disinfect and squeeze the acne well. But don't do it yourself ever. Always go to a professional to do it. Otherwise, it can leave a harsh dark marks on your skin. In the case of fungal acne, which is different from comedones, it needs more complex treatment. Especially, you need to be very careful about the cosmetic ingredients you're using. And also, it may not be good to use too many cosmetics, because you need to make sure that you have antibacterial properties in your product, so there's no further growth of any fungal acne on your skin. We understand it can be tricky to understand the difference between whiteheads, blackheads, and fungal acne, and it can be tricky. So it has been a little difficult for us to judge her skin concern properly as well. But as Richie has mentioned that she has issues of whiteheads and folliculitis, and they look very similar. So we are going to go ahead with the treatment suggestions, keeping in mind folliculitis. So Richie says that Korean skincare has really helped me fading rather than the conventional dermatologists. And she has been using a lot of acid creams and chemical peels that have just ruined my skin and made my skin more prone to hyperpigmentation. I'm so sorry to hear that. We totally understand the struggle it is to actually find the right kind of product that actually helps your skin rather than making it worse. That's why we've actually tried our best to suggest you the right kind of products, and we really hope it helps you. Let's look at a little about her lifestyle. So she says that she exercises 3 times a week and drinks 3 liters of water a day. You're doing great. You're doing a fab job, girl. Keep on doing it, because exercise and eating well is as important as treating as your skin from the outside. So now let's start analyzing Richie's morning skincare routine. So you actually follow a very simple skincare routine in the morning, Richie. You follow it. You started with a Sebamed Acne Foam Face Wash, and you use an Innisfree Aloe Soothing Gel, and after that a Vitamin C Serum with Airy Surprise Sunscreen by Etude House. So it's not bad to have a simple skincare routine. I think rather if it's doing the job well for you, you need to have a simple skincare routine, because the simpler the better, and if it works well for you, then great. But I would like to say here, why don't you use a toner? We believe that if you add a toner in your routine, it will really help you. Anyone on to the type of cleansing that Richie is currently doing. So Richie is actually using a Sebamed Clear Face Cleansing Foam for acne prone skin. This is a well-known product and it's been actually used by quite a few people and they say that it's quite effective. However, we would like to point out here, it has a few ingredients which can irritate the skin like perfume and phenoxyethanol. So these ingredients can actually irritate the skin further. So we would like to recommend another product in place of this. We'd like to recommend Cosrx Low pH Good Morning Gel Cleanser. This gel cleanser has a very gel-like texture. It foams up after applying on the skin with water. It is low pH and it's very mild and gentle on the skin. This type of cleanser is great in mornings because when we wake up in the morning, we don't really have any makeup on our skin. We're not stepping out, so we're not getting ourselves exposed to any dirt or impurities in the air. So it's a perfect skincare product you would want to use during the daytime. We also suggest a Hemish pH 5.5 All Clean Green Foam. This product is okay to use both mornings and evenings. It's still going to be gentle on your skin and you can use it both times. So whichever you like, we would suggest that you go for either of them. Now we move on to the serum that Richie is using. So we notice that Richie is using a Truderma Vitamin C Serum. So she's probably using this vitamin C serum because it's good for pigmentation as we saw that she has this concern and she probably wants to treat her dark spots. However, vitamin C is vulnerable to sunlight. I recommend you start using it during nighttime and ditch it using during the day. There are some products that can be used during the daytime that are made of suitable vitamin C derivatives and not vitamin C directly. So I suggest that you prioritize treating your comedones and acne and whiteheads first and then moving to treating your pigmentation. So that's why we would recommend you to stop using it for a short period of time. Maybe you can use it during the night time and we'll come on that later. So another product recommendation here would be of AC Clear Magic Gel from Plant Base. So this has a gel-like texture. So as we notice that you do not like to use something sticky on your skin, this will be perfect. It also has natural AHA magic which works on troubled spot and area, so it'll actually help to treat your skin concerns. Also, it has an anti-spot technology which visibly corrects pimple darkening and eliminates excess of oil in your skin. So it's actually a great product that we would recommend you to add in place of a vitamin C serum. This is recommended for the following people. People who have acne, people who need to remove acne scars, and people who want flawless skin. So we would suggest you to try this and see if it works well for you. Further noticing her skincare routine, we notice that she's currently not using any cream. From serum, she's straight away going to using an SPF. And we understand it's uncomfortable to use probably heavy cream during day, especially right now. It's so hot that we don't want to put something which is heavy on our skin and further, you know, makes it very sticky or oily and further cause more acne. So we would, however, recommend to try Benton Aloe Propolis Gel. So propolis ingredient has antibacterial properties. So when you do apply on your skin, you're also actually giving it the right moisture because moisturizer is an important step in your skincare routine and we would not tell you to ditch it because it's important right now to give your skin the right nourishment. So especially this gel will also help you containing moisture. At the same time, it will also give you a cooling effect with antibacterial effect. So it will prevent further acne. So you are treating your current skin concerns and making sure that they are treated and you know they're going away and your sebum is releasing out of your whiteheads. But at the same time, you're also ensuring that you're preventing further acne to come into place by making sure you're applying a moisturizer which retains the moisture in the skin, which holds the moisture as well as acts in an antibacterial. So there are no germs on your skin and your skin's gonna be healthier. Moving on, you're currently using a Etude House Airy Surprise Sunscreen. To be honest, I think your sun cream is okay. We've reviewed your skincare routine and we feel that your sunscreen is doing a good job, fairly good job. It works well for the type of skin you have. So we'd say a thumbs up on that and go ahead with it. So let's look into Richie's night skincare routine now. So for her night skincare routine, we see she's using the technique of double cleansing, which is quite an effective way to deeply clean the skin. She's using an MCT oil for her fungal acne, and she's claiming that it has helped to reduce it a lot. She's using a Hemish cleanser after that. So though I understand that she's saying that her skin has improved after using MCT oil, I would not highly recommend it. Though MCT oil is better than a lot of other oils available in the market like the vegetable oil or the olive oil, but still it's not the best remedy for fungal acne. So I would suggest that for the night time, you're already using Hemish 5.5 All Clean Green Foam. You can continue using that because it's a product which focuses on moisturizing and calming. However, I would suggest it's a good idea to use a cleanser that is more effective to deeply clean your skin by removing the dead cells. And here I would like to suggest that you can try Cosrx Salicylic Acid Cleanser. So as we we know, salicylic acid daily cleanser, it's one of the most recommended cleanser for exfoliating skin, and it also helps to remove the dead impurities and dead cells of the skin. And if you also want to focus on calming the sensitive skin, I recommend that you use the plant-based AC Clair Magic Foam. The plant-based AC Magic line has now become very popular. A lot of people have actually used it and said that it's worked very well on their skin. It helps in calming the skin and also making it soothing. So as we've recommended you to try out Salicylic Acid Daily Cleanser by COSRX, let us talk about the ingredient BHA. So BHAs are beta hydroxy acids. These are oil soluble exfoliant acids that have the capability to dig deeper inside the skin. As they penetrate deeper into the skin, they not only help with removal of dead skin cells from the surface of the skin, but also regulate sebum production. These type of acids are very good for skin which is oily and congested. So if you have a skin which is prone to acne and blackheads, BHAs are a definite try for you. Also, their kind of BHA is popular in the market, but the most popular ingredient, which is a BHA, is salicylic acid. Moving on to the toner that she's using at night time. So she's using a Clair Supple Preparation Facial Toner. So this has a lot of good moisturizing ingredients, which are great for the skin, and it's actually quite a popular toner. But however, I recommend you to use a toner which is oil-free, as this toner has oil, and it may not be the perfect fit for your skin. So I have a few recommendations that are going to work better in hydrating your skin with the toner, as well as not making it oily or sticky. So the first suggestion would be from COSRX. So this product is AC Collection Calming Liquid Intensive. So this product contains propolis and tea tree, and they both have antibacterial properties. So it actually works well for the skin which is which has active acne issues and, you know, other issues like comedones. So if you want to use only one toner, this is probably the best because it has both AHA and BHA in it. So the second recommendation that I have for you is another product from COSRX. So this is Centella Water Alcohol Free Toner. This is a mild toner with a soothing ingredient, and it's without oil. So it's actually very mild on the skin, and it also soothes the skin. So it leaves like a cooling effect on the skin. So it'll help you feel very fresh at night. It's good to moisturize your skin without oil. If you feel that your skin is feeling too oily, I also recommend you to definitely use this product. After using the product, it would be better to use another moisturizer together. So it will also help to moisturize your skin and make it more effective if you use a moisturizer after this step. And the last recommendation for toner will be the Soothe Bamboo Toner. So this is one of the most popular toner from Keep Cool, and it's actually done wonders for people's skin. To be honest, even I personally use this toner because I have sensitive skin and it can get red very quickly, and this toner really helps in soothing the skin, making sure that there is no further acne, because prevention is as important as treating the concerns. And this is made up with 85% of bamboo water, which also has antibacterial properties. So it's good to use every day without irritation. So this is highly recommended product from our end, and you can use it daily. So moving on to the last step of your skincare routine, you're currently using Benton Aloe Propolis Gel. So this is a good product, and as we recommend it for the daytime as well, we firmly believe this product is doing well for your skin and has the capability to do further good if you use it with the other recommended products, which are going to do justice to your skin concern and treatment. So definitely go ahead using this product. We feel it's great. So that's all. That's us reviewing Richie's morning and night skincare routine. So for this skincare journey of yours, we've actually focused on products which have ingredients that work really well for calming and soothing the active acne. We haven't really given you any product to treat your pigmentation. So we would recommend you to first treat your first skin concern, which is of active acne. Use calming ingredients, soothing ingredients. That's why ingredients like Centella, bamboo and tea tree are good for your skin. So we really hope, Richie, that this skincare routine analysis or overview and the suggestions we've given you helps you, and also it helps our other audience who are probably dealing with the same issues of active acne, comedones, and they want something which helps them soothe their skin. So we really hope it helps you all. Until then, see you next time. Bye guys, subscribe to our channel if you haven't already, and stay tuned on our platform for more information. Bye.